What's up, guys? Ghost Rider 822-005 here, bringing us another action figure review. And today I will be reviewing the Marvel Legends Hulk Build-A-Figure Wave in-game War Machine. And I just got him today for my sister for my birthday. She pre-ordered him for me. Early birthday. My birthday is not till August 2nd. But yeah, window box, you see two weapons, armor, shoulder cannon, figure. Side, you see actual art. Oh yeah, my box got damaged, so I've been putting tape on it so it stays together, like here and here. Here, so that if you're wondering why, that's why. But yeah, art, the concept art, which I remember first seeing this and thought it was awesome. Back, well, concept art, yeah, the entire wave. I do plan on finishing this because I need a regular Hulk that's not Gladiator Hulk. Side, same art. Bottom, legal crap, there is the serial code. And you, yeah, so let's go to it and crack this guy up. And here is War Machine, all the packaging, and he is a really, really nice figure, actually. He is definitely a beefcake. Yeah, he has very incorrect paint apps. He did not look like this. He's more Iron Patriot in the movie. And I actually have some messy paint apps on him. But I do have my black Sharpie to fix that on camera when we go into detail. But yeah, let's get into this guy's accessories. So, looking at War Machine's accessories, he comes with three guns and all. He comes with these two under the arm guns, shoulder guns. I do not have any effects from right now, but I will probably put some on there. Yeah, they can plug in right here on that little hole right there. Just plug in, and they can like rotate, but I'm not sure why you'd want that. You know, if you really want to, you can get him holding one of them. If you really want to, you can get him holding one of them, which looks kind of strange, but I will always have them just plugged in right there. And looking into War Machine's, again, tripod broken, so it doesn't work properly. Okay, going into War Machine's other accessory, he comes with his shoulder cannon, which I really do like. Do have a problem with it, though. Putting on the figure, you know, it ports in nice, you know, it's a ball joint, you know, it rotates like that, and tilts, but doesn't go up at all. Like, you go up at all, it pops off. You can, like, kinda go up, but, like, you just pick it. Well, I guess, okay, it's not doing it, of course, here, but, like, again, like, you do that, it comes off too quick. But, yeah, like, you don't have, it basically, when you do it like this, you have to half it. Like, it's not all the way pegged in, but it's not pegged in to where it will go up. Same thing with pointing down. But what I'm probably going to do is take an X-Acto knife, cut a little piece out here so it can actually just go up a little more. But yeah, okay, going into detail, and this is where I said I wanted to fix the paint apps on him. And some of the paint apps have a few problems, like there. Let me get my light. So actually, look, okay, yeah, this is my light. Get paint apps right there messed up. Of course, I can't find them at the moment. There's one on one of the guns. Not that gun. I think it's this gun. Oh crap, where'd that missing paint apps part go? It was on there somewhere. There it is, right there. That's the messed up paint apps. So we're gonna fix that on camera with a black Sharpie. Okay, so yeah, okay. Crap, that's really in there, is it? See, this is like a piece of dirt I can get out with some scissors. Okay, be careful. Okay. I think it is a piece of dirt. Okay, come on, because paint apps are a big deal. Yep, just a piece of dirt. Okay, moving that out of this way. And this is gonna fix those little paint apps on the shoulder. He has right here, right on the shoulder, the chest right there. That bothers me a little bit, so we're just gonna touch it up a little bit. Boop. Yeah, it's really obvious there, but I can rub it a little bit. Okay, well, it's still kind of there. I need to get, like, a more light black color. But yeah, you just gotta, like, put a little bit, rub it. Put a little bit, rub it. Now it's virtually gone. But yeah, that works out great. And done. Alright, but yeah, moving the light away for a little bit. But yeah, that detail on this figure is really great. The sculpt is amazing. He is gigantic, actually. like, comparing them next to your average 6-inch figure. I don't really have... I don't have any of my MCU Marvel figures with me at the moment. They're at my other house. So, yeah, I can bring him to your 6-inch figure. You know, he can just get blasted away. But yeah, let's get into this figure's articulation. So, going into articulation, again with this thing, it goes up that much, I guess. Down that much, I guess. It swivels like that. Kind of tilt like that. The head looks up that much, just doing it that way. But like, if you just kind of like lift up the head a little bit, you look up more. Looks down a lot. Shoulders has plastic pieces. I really like these. Move out that much. Down all the way. Rotate all the way around. He has a bicep swivel in there. Single jointed elbows that swivel too. He has wrist articulation that swivels and hinges down and up. Putting this piece back on right here because I'm probably never going to have this off the figure. But yeah, he has a diaphragm joint that swivels right there. It crunches forward, not that much. Back a little more, you know, a lot of diaphragm movement. Kicks forward, that's much. Back, that much. Out a lot, more than Spider-Man. Upper thigh cut. Double, it's really stiff double joint knees. He has ankles that move down that much. They do move up. And this is the first War Machine figure for me to own that has ankle pivot. Thank the maker. Ooh, I was getting really tired not having War Machine ankle pivot. But yeah, let's get into a stop motion segment of him fighting this guy. This guy, and let's put Han Solo in there, because I guess why not, and, we'll throw in Boba Fett. Okay, I'm trying to get Boba Fett to stand, he's really difficult to stand. 3, 2, 1, go. So, going into size comparisons, don't have many MCU figures to compare him to. I hope you guys like that stop motion. Dude, that one didn't take long, but I'm so proud of how that came out. You have no idea. Alright, so going into some size comparisons. Here he is next to the MCU Iron Spider. I really hope to find that 2-pack of him in the new Iron Man at some point. That would be really cool to find. And here he is next to the only other MCU figure I own. It is the Marvel Legends Molten Man Build-A-Figure Wave. Mysterio, and I do feel like Mysterio is still a little short. I don't know, I feel like he's a little too short. I think he should be like at least up here, maybe. That'd be a lot closer to what I want Mysterio to be. But he scales really well. So let's get into my final thoughts of the figure. And my final thoughts of the figure is he's really nice. He's definitely my favorite War Machine in my collection. Probably my favorite in-game figure so far. Yeah, I hope to finish the Hulk Build-A-Figure Wave. I hope to review all of them. I probably will review all of them. But yeah, like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll catch you guys next time. And peace. Also, thank you, Caitlin Lily, for getting this for me. Best sister ever. Thank you for the birthday present.